Can you imagine having a reach advantage like this? What a luxury!
It's a luxury. I've never had one over the course of my entire career. But fighting guys that are taller, you struggle whenever they are very aware of such a massive advantage. This guy is going to try and use this tonight.
Well-placed kick there by DC. Just out of range with that right hook.
You gotta check these low leg kicks.
And he lands a punch there. Pretty good connection by him.
Great connection. He's in a great flow right now.
Oh, combination lands. You want to talk about putting strikes together. Beautiful execution there.
And every one of them are landing. He's overwhelming him with different attacks.
Well, missed on that one. Right hand. Strong outside leg kick.
Oh! He needs to start looking to finish now because he's got his opponent hurt very bad.
Oh! Oh, straight right. So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Daniel Cormier. That's a huge shot there, DC. I'm not sure how he stayed up. He's out! Just an absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, he saw that little crack of an opening and marched ready for the official decision.
If I make another wish, I'll wish for West Steel.
For you. Hey.
One, two.
ECAD, you heard of these lads. The myth that we made a grip, never broke. Truly the Cadillac, I had to contract L's on a quick.
Dick em up, slick, talking no tricks.
It's the funniest shit. Finally, the money up and print on the kid, and the planet hit skids. Living in a valley of flames, like I win. Skyline of blaze, and a Bob Ross pick. You don't want to acknowledge them wrong. Give a shit, never nigh. You can talk to me fine when I'm gone. Bad news bearing along with big claws, trying to hold our whole lives in his paws and applaud. Swear to goddamn, the whole city, I make a bullman's heart. We got scars for hearts. Shit for eyes, baby, living in a one chance box.
Coming up next, it's a UFC featherweight division fight.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, so we got two classically trained strikers here. Any chance this fight actually goes to the ground?
This fight does not go to the ground. This one will be fought in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other. They will trade punches. They will trade kicks. It's going to be a classic matchup that you normally see inside of a ring. We get it in the octagon tonight.
Oh, big roundhouse attempt. Just misses.
That one snuck in. Nice strike.
Oh, big hook, that'll sting.
That was a jab.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Well, he continues to do a nice job here defensively, protecting the head and sort of maybe letting his opponent gas out a little bit with all the volume.
His opponent sees the target, but he can't get to the target. So he'll continue to throw, and he'll continue to wear on his own gas tank.
Unable to land with that punch. Oh, big head kick there. Slips that left hand. Ooh. Wow.
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad. He's hurt bad.
Oh, he might be out. Shades of Ben Saunders against Brandon Wolf back in the day. A lot of knees, a lot of volume here. I'm not sure how many more he can take.
My boy John Anik is an encyclopedia of knowledge and threw it all the way back.
Oh! Oh! He gets on the feet and moving in a lot of trouble now.
That was Cain Velasquez.
And just like that, the fight is over.
He's done. What a performance.
absolutely gorgeous shot to spell the end for his opponent. Crowd is absolutely loving it. He gets the near-perfect land. I'm not even sure his opponent saw it coming, but just the way he drew it up here tonight, saw that little crack of an opening and barged right through it to get the knockout. Watch Bruce Buffer inside the octagon. Coming up next, it's a UFC featherweight division fight.
Ready. Ready to fight.
Good to have you with us tonight from T-Mobile Arena, the home of the NHL's Vegas Golden Knights and the building in which DC shocked some of the MMA world at UFC 226, but this venue will always have a special place for you.
This venue holds a special place in my heart. UFC 226, I became the double champion. This is a fight venue that you should want to compete in. A great arena where you can make history. Tonight, you get your chance.
Oh! Huge right hand! Squirming like a fish out of water now. The ground and pound is on point. This could very well be the beginning of the end.
This could be the beginning of the end. We've seen some really good ground and pound fighters. This young man is as good as any we've ever seen.
Another knockout!
Nowadays, you see guys just throwing little shots that don't really matter. Very few guys now are committed to ground and pound as they were in the past.
Clinch work. Nice job to land a knee to the body, man. I wish I was that tall. Oh, nice job to land the knee there by the taller fighter. And I think I just heard Daniel Cormier say, I wish I was a little bit taller. You're a baller, though, DC. So 41 total strikes have landed for Max Holloway. Oh, nice kick right there. Tell the masses how good that feels to get kicked like that.
John, it doesn't. It doesn't feel good to get kicked.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there.
Look at him drive his shin into his opponent's body with that body kick. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range. Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
Back and forth we go. A devastating shot to the body that clearly hurt his opponent. He folded like a lawn chair, just unable to defend himself because he was writhing in pain. So good stoppage there by the referee. The official decision. All right, coming up next, a UFC featherweight division fight.
Ready. Ready to fight.
All right, right, so we got two classically trained strikers here. Any chance this fight actually goes to the ground?
This fight does not go to the ground. This one will be fought in the pocket. Two guys will stand in front of each other. They will trade punches. They will trade kicks. It's going to be a classic matchup that you normally see inside of a ring. We get it in the octagon tonight.
Lands with a right hand. Just misses with a left hook there. Well, it's one thing to have length. It's another thing to use it, and he does it as well as anyone. Nice kick there by Holloway. Strong defense here as the hook to the head is blocked.
Right under the elbow, the body kick lands. Big, powerful punch lands. Now he gets back to range.
Well, that one should leave a mark. Outstanding leg kick employed there by Holloway. Boom! And another leg kick lands flush, and now you're starting to see visible damage on that lead leg of his opponent.
Visible damage, and you see him starting to make mistakes now in his defenses because his leg is so beat up. It's red, it's all beat up, he's limping, he's turning away. There are so many things that he is doing.
A huge strike lands there, DC.
He landed that massive shot. Now he needs to try to find the next shot, the follow-up shot that will finish the fight.
Just over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one. So just over 20 total strikes have landed for Max Holloway.
Big punch lands over the top. How's he gonna follow this one up?
Oh, and there's a takedown attempt there, DC. I'm no analyst, but that one was pretty telegraphed, not his best effort.
Yes, he may as well have sent a text message to his opponent saying, I'm going to shoot the moment the fight starts. Of course, he got defended. Set up your attack, young man. Oh. What a fantastic strike to throw at the exact right moment.
Home, and now his opponent in a world of trouble.
Such a sneaky head kick. He did not recognize it. It was coming high, and now he's got him hurt bad.
Oh, big head kick there.
Look at him whip his hip into that kick.
Trying to find a home for that right hand. Oh!
He's in trouble. He's hurt bad.
Oh! Huge right hand! Round two winding down. All right, 5 minutes more in the books, and you see the cut on his eyebrow is only getting worse. Pretty nasty gash there. The cut man's gonna do what he can, but of course, oftentimes, as soon as you absorb another strike.
You ready to fight? Ready. Good.
Look at the whip action that comes from him throwing that kick.
All right, so he's landed some good shots. You hate to be overly critical, but nothing really in terms of combinations tonight.
Well, the jab has been looking great. How about jab, jab, right hand?
Right.
Because eventually you're going to have to put some.
Thus far, how's his opponent still standing?
I mean, I have no idea. This fight is supposed to be over. And it might not be over now, but it's going to be over very soon.
So aggressive with his onslaught that ultimately appeared as though the outcome was an eventuality. So if you're the referee, you got to protect the fighter, and I thought he did a good job of doing just that. Here is Bruce Buffer with the official.